Hello. Did you like the new intro?
Nah, I don't know.
Just trying out new things. Anyway, this is a bit of a personal project, like this whole channel is. We've got the song, if you can see it on the screen there. It's called FDT by the late, great Nipsey Hussle and the always talented and exciting YG. This is a bit of an oldie. This song I'm doing as a final political message. It was my birthday on Sunday. Sing it. Anyway, we'll get back to that. This video is what I hope to be the last time I mention it for at least a month or whenever the election is. I just want to make a statement and hope I can talk to someone and convince someone that maybe their current way of thinking isn't great. And for anyone who agrees with me, we can get some goddamn hype. Because I know if this dirty son of a gun loses the election, this song is going to be on repeat. This isn't a reaction. I've heard this song far too often, and it's an absolute fucking banger. Alright, the nitty-gritty details. I wrote them down. I know it's a bit sad, but I just did. Of why I dislike Donald Trump as a list, in listicle form. Look, all the shit that's going on in the world, let's just go quick and easy, handling of coronavirus, fucking deplorable. Deplorable. He'll tell you it's great. His staff will tell you he's great. If you look at the numbers, deplorable. Don't look at his numbers. And people are dying. Him being a slack, political, selfish bastard, people are dying. I don't like that. No one should accept it, no matter who you are, and particularly people of colour who are the ones dying, shouldn't accept that. It's just disgusting. And I reckon there's two camps. There's people like myself who just straight up hate him, and the supporters. So if you're a supporter of him, stick with me. Maybe, if you wish to. He's just a single, self-serving asshole. Like, well and truly is just looking out for number one this whole time. Every statement he makes is a lie. You may think he's got your best interests at heart, or he's going to make business boom, but he doesn't, or he won't, or he's had 3 wins and 48,000 promises that he hasn't kept. So it's just, everything he tells you is absolute bullshit. I would say that as well. If you're thinking of voting for him, just do some fact-checking. Listen to a statement he makes, check it. Statement, check it. Check it yourself. Don't even use the media, the whatever it is, Marxism or whatever other shit you talk about. So fact-check him. Also listen to when he doesn't answer a question. It's pretty simple, like, that he's lying to as well, when he stalls and stalls and just goes around, which is what politicians do, but, like, he's so painful to hear talk about it. It just gets under my skin. That's the video. I also just really want to point out that I don't think he believes in God. He doesn't seem like a holy person. The story behind him getting to that church to take that photo was really fucked up. So if you think he's representing God and family values, no. No, he's ripping families apart. He hates immigrants, and I've got nothing against this. His wife is an immigrant, so he's just a hypocrite. He's just a terrible lying bastard that will tell you one thing and do another. So this is it. That's my spiel. I think I've got some more points here, but this is an important one. If you're around me and agree, I would highly recommend, I love 6 Summers by Anderson .Paak. Any Black Lives Matter movement songs, they're all amazing, and I think they all represent the world, but also a life and tradition and society in American culture in which black people are oppressed. So Trump, at the figurehead of that movement, directly speaking to the Proud Boys, telling them to back down, is like, oh, which we all knew, but, like, less evidence was available. You're in their camp. Oh, you don't care about us. Anyway, so yes, go listen to Anderson .Paak, 6 Summers. Also, the instrumentals and the switch on that are really nice. Let's get it. If you haven't heard this song before, it's a fucking banger. It truly is. Love what these two do. What a great collab, YG and Nip. I hope you're liking what I'm putting out, everyone. We've got a really exciting song today. Give me a like. Give me a subscribe if you wish. If you don't, don't. we'll do it and then take them away later. Oh. FDT, take it away, YG Nip. Retrospectively, this is also phenomenal. I've never seen this film clip, so this is gonna be fun. Yeah, retrospectively, correct. Most importantly, go and vote. Just go and vote. For us, it's nice and simple because it's mandatory here, which is shit. But in being mandatory, you can just walk in, get your name ticked off, and walk out. You don't have to vote. You just have to show up to vote, like register to vote. So yes, we have to do it. It seems like it's a big burden for America. Maybe not as big a burden as another 4 years of hatred, lies, oppression, the media, ridiculousness, and just, yeah. Anyway, this is really fucked up. Yeah, it felt that way, I thought so. Look, there were some issues with Obama, like most politicians. Either way, you're going to get shit politicians, most likely. It's kind of a lesser of two evils, but some of them do better than good, but they're never perfect. Idiots for being like, oh, I'm only left, I'm only right. Look at the people and the policies and decide on that. Don't let anything else determine who you are, what you are. Otherwise, you're a sucker. You're a goddamn sucker. So yes, things were looking a bit better. Retrospectively as well, Trump repealed a crazy amount of laws that Obama passed. Huh? Look where we are now. Probably hasn't been said either, but maybe assumed. I'm from Australia. Like, this doesn't affect me, but what does affect me and gets into my heart is the hatred this spreads. And I know it's in a lot of countries, but because of rap and this is the narrative I'm on, I follow it. So it doesn't directly affect me, but it's suffering and horrible things happening in the world. So just, this is my expression video. Go FDT, register and vote. Pretty pivotal president. This seems like a pretty pivotal time in America's history and culture, and I would say it's not looking great for you. Fall of Rome comes to mind. Age of technical powers. Yeah, KOD. It's 2017. Why can't we vote from the apps in our machines? How good would the voting app be? I mean, probably get politicized and corrupt somehow, but I'd be mad. Let's get the song going. Woo! Hate.
YG and Nipsey Hussle's video got shut down by cops for an anti-Trump song that's called Donald Trump.
I think we got kicked out because we're a group of black people, and like, I guess people, what's going on in America, they're afraid we're gonna say something or do something, but we just really want to watch the rally, and to get kicked out because we're a group of black people is really crazy. It shows you how racist our own school is. We can't even go to our own school.
Fuck Donald Trump. Fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald.
I've also got Genius up. just for a bit of fun to see exactly what they're talking about. If I get caught or whatever. It'd be also really cool to see the filming of why they got shut down. Like, was there someone on their camera, maybe, yeah, someone IG living it up and they weren't doing anything? Or was it a bit hectic?
I like white folks, but I don't like you. All the niggas in the hood wanna fight you. Surprise, El Chapo ain't.
That would be so good. Just on his own strolling through the hood or anywhere. And just, fuck, people would come out in their droves. Yeah, also pretty hectic. There are probably places, I mean, they just send SWAT in and clean her out. But, like, there are places that the president can't or shouldn't go.
Ain't tried to snipe you, surprise the nation of Islam ain't tried to find you. Have a rally out LA, we gon' fuck it up. Home of the ride and the king ride, we don't give a fuck. Black students ejected from your rally. What? I'm ready to go right now, your racist ass did too much. I'm about to turn Black Panther. Don't let Donald Trump win, that nigga cancer. He too rich, he ain't got the answers. He can't make decisions for this country, he gon' crash.
Rumor is he's fucking broke. Like, lost all his money, or has so many loans out that he can't pay back. So rumor is he's kind of broke. And if his tax returns are coming back, he's losing even more money. So people talk about the success story that is. And look, sure, he's had some wins. Definitely got some wins on the board, and he's the fucking president. Even though I think he's just a con artist. But yeah, I just don't think he's actually that successful. Yeah. So just maybe a misconception.
Too much. I'm about to turn Black Panther. Don't let Donald Trump win, that nigga cancer. He too rich, he ain't got the answers. He can't make decisions for this country, he gon' crash us. No, we can't be a slave for him. He got me appreciating, nobody way more. Hey Donald, and everyone that follows, you gave us your reason to be president, but we hate
you. Fuck Donald Trump. Fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump.
I don't like your
yeah,
ass.
Yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump.
Like, I know they're throwing up signs and shit, but I truly don't know what it means. Like, that's who I represent. But I don't know what he's saying or who he's representing through those actions. Maybe that's exactly what they want. Also, just so much culture there. There's so much life and community, and good or bad, it's all there. Which, as a just a pretty straighty 180 white boy, I have none of that, none of it. So yes, in doing this also, I'm a cultural vulture, I guess. Hopefully I'd push the culture forward as well a little bit, you know. I'll just do something to it, but I genuinely love it.
Yeah, yeah, so fuck Donald Trump. Yeah.
Nigga, am I tripping? Let me know. I thought all that Donald Trump bullshit was a joke. Know what they say when rich niggas go broke. Look, Reagan so cold, Obama so hope, Donald Trump spent his trust for money on the vote.
Yep.
I'm from a place where you.
Yeah. No one's perfect. I'm coming from no sides of this. These guys maybe are. You don't have to be Republican or Democratic. We have liberal and Labor. It's just, it's so bad that it's a two-horse race. And again, each one comes in, as Nick was saying, selling hope, selling whatever else. Trump, fear. I mean, they sell fear. Trump sells hatred. Don't know what Nip actually said, but I'd say he sells hatred and division. That's been his tactic, and that's worked. So it's not exclusively a dislike of Donald. They're all pretty bad, but this guy's just a real scumbag.
Probably can't go. Speaking for some people that you probably
run it back.
Look, Reagan's so cold, Obama's so hope, Donald Trump spent his trust for money on the vote. I'm from a place where you probably can't go.
Speaking for some people that you probably ain't know. It's pressure built up and it's probably gonna blow. And if we say go, then they probably gonna go. You vote Trump, then you probably on dope. And if you like me, then you probably ain't know. And if you been in jail, you could probably still vote. If we let this nigga win, we gon' probably feel broke. You build walls, we gon' probably dig holes. And if your ass do win, you gon' probably get smoked,
fuck
nigga.
Down, Trump.
Fuck you.
Fuck down.
Also, these guys are rapping their asses off. That's just such a nice... He's writing that beat perfectly. His rhyme schemes are really nice to listen to. He had me so hypnotized and does every time. Nip was a fucking genius. I found out far too late. I'd recommend go back listening to... Not Forest Hill Drive. That's Cole Crenshaw. Something Crenshaw. And his other one. Yes, so whilst I love everything about this song, the message, the beat, that nice little keyboard in the end when it comes in with the maybe just a triangle, and these two fucking geniuses rapping their asses off on this song. Yeah, love it.
Try, yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah.
I will build a great, great wall.
Didn't. Fact check. Didn't.
On our southern border, and I will have Mexico pay for that wall.
Didn't. Mexico. Like, I think the facts, well, they've paid legal fees or whatever. They've paid nothing. America paid for it. So whilst he's not paying his goddamn fucking taxes... His taxes alone could fund half this wall he's probably talking about. But he didn't do it. That was his promise. That's what he keeps lying. He'll say he's built the wall. No. It's breaking down.
Yeah. Mark my words.
Yeah. Hold up, I fuck with Mexicans. Got a plug with Mexicans. When a little need a switch, who I call Mexican. This Comedy Central ass nigga come be the president. Hold up, Nip, tell the world how you fuck with Mexicans.
It wouldn't be the USA without Mexicans. And if it's time to team up, shit, let's begin. Black love, brown pride, and the sense again. White people.
Just thinking about this, and as a matter of being an ignorant fool, Black Lives Matter can be a catalyst for and a representation of what it should be for all races, being Black, Mexican, Asian, any race. I wonder how people feel, like how do the Mexicans feel with the attention and the movement of the Black Lives Matter? Are they not like, so do our lives? How do we get in on this action? I guess you've just got to fight your struggle, and you can't fight everyone's struggle all at once. And if the Black Lives Matter movement wins, then there could be a Mexican Lives Matter movement. And hopefully that slippery slope has started and we realize that, yes, those lives matter. I'm truly doing my best to avoid saying all lives matter, because I think that is the case. And the problem is the inequalities that currently exist that make it so important for Black Lives Matter to exclusively matter. Shit, what a rambling rabbit hole. I really want to be respectful and also learn. Everything I say, nothing I say is nothing I say is perfect. I'm here to learn as well. So if I've fucked up in any of that explanation, I'd love to humbly learn.
People feel the same as my next of kin. Let's the USA without Mexicans. And if it's time to team up, shit, let's begin. Black love, brown pride, and assess again. White people feel the same as my next of kin. Let this nigga win, God bless the kids.
God bless the kids, this nigga wicked and weird. When me and Nibbling.
Does he say this guy's wicked and weird? On to Genius Now. Yeah, he's wicked and... Oh, and wigged. Damn it. What's the wig bit? Is that his stupid, queefy top bit? He's wicked and wigged. I really wanted that to be weird. Just because he is weird. It's so weird. Him as a human is weird. Imagine him... like doing something a normal human would do. And you can't count sitting on his ass watching Fox News, because that's very believable. I mean, like, sitting around and having dinner with his family and then tucking his kid into bed. He's just such a weird old orange creep. Oops.
That's Bloods and Crips. When your LA rally, we gon' crash your shit. Fuck Donald Trump. Fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, yeah, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you. And, oh, did you? Oh, I thought I heard you singing happy birthday to me. This is it. Now, thankfully, what I can also do is wash my hands of this. I don't need to talk about this fuck anymore, and I can remove him from my life. The narrative and following anything he says or does is totally pointless, because it's all lies. If he's there giving a speech, you don't need to click on it. It's lies. Check some, like, and it sucks because in that way it kind of feels like you're burying your head in the sand. But for my mental health, it's great. And if you're able to check out from any of this crap, I would highly recommend it, because this is Trump's next level, The Apprentice. It's just a big reality stage for him to stroke his cute little ego and play with the big boys. But he's quite a pathetic little fuck. So I hope I've expressed myself enough. Happy birthday to me. Unfollow anything that has the name of Donald Trump in it. Thank you so much for sticking with me. I hope you've liked this one. Sorry about the crazy ramblings. This is That's a Wrap. Like, subscribe, do all that. YG and Nipsey Hussle. Fuck Donald Trump.